nation's natal day, proclaimed throughout the bounds of Antioch a feast, a solemn sacrifice to Jove. Whose who disdains to join the sacred rites shall feel our wrath in chastisement or death. And this, Septimius, take you in charge. Go, my faithful soldier, go.
Thank you. as ear to my request. Let not thy sentence doom to wrecks and flames. All whose scrupulous minds will not permit them. Or to bend the knee to gods they know not. Or in wanton mood to celebrate the day with Roman rites.
Art thou a Roman? And yet thus defend a sect rebellious to the gods and Rome.
Many the Antioch who disdain an idle offering, yet our friends to Caesar.
It cannot be, we are not Caesar's friends, who are not Caesar's gods. I'll be no more.
Thank you. Must be obeyed. Such is the Roman discipline, while we can only pity whom we dare not spare.
Thank you. Hey! heathen rage pursues us swift, armed with the terrors of insulting death.
Ah, oh, whither should we fly, or fly from whom? The Lord is still the same today, forever, and his protection here and everywhere. Though gathering round our destined heads, the storm now thickens and looks big with fate, still shall thy servants wait on thee.
mistaken wretches! Why thus blind to fate do ye in private oratories dare rebel against the president's decree? And scorn with native rites to celebrate the day sacred to Caesar and protecting Jove.
Deluded mortal, call it not rebellion to worship God. It is his dread command, his whom we cannot, dare not disobey, for death be our reward.
Death is not yet thy doom, but worse than death to such a virtuous mind. Lady, these guards are ordered to convey you to the vile place. A prostitute to devote your charms.
Alas, she's gone to lead thou camest to see.
Thank you.
grateful sacrifice to Jove. And while your songs ascend the boded skies, or on their smoking altar floods of wine, in honor of the smiling deities, fair Flora and the Cyprian queen.
Queen of summer, queen of
Thank you.
strings to join me in a singing, ever-loving choir of saints and angels in the courts above. Septimius, I am a Christian, and she who by heaven's influential grave with pure religious sentiments inspired my soul, with virtue's love inflamed my heart, even she who, shame to all humanity, is now condemned to public lust.
No more! The shame reflects too much upon my friend, the mean, though duteous instrument of power, knowing her virtues only, not thy love.
to save my free admission to the imprisoned maid.
My guards, not less ashamed of their vile office, will second your intent and pleasure me.
I will reward them with a bounteous heart, and you, my friend, with all that heaven can give to the sincerity of prayer. The clouds begin to veil the hemisphere, and heaven bring on the night. your deliverer, and that dear ornament for Theodora, dear angelic Eurydice, if you vouchsafe but to change heaven with your Didymus.
Excellent youth, I know thy courage, virtue, and thy love. This becomes not Theodora, but the blind enemies of truth. Oh no, it must not be. Didymus can live, a boon will make me happy.
Oh, oh, what? My soul with transport listens to the request. If not, his will be
Thank you.
to boundless love and joys ineffable, and such an expectation from kind heaven.
Dwells there such virtuous courage in the sex? Preserve them, O ye gods, preserve them both.
Opus nativus, my justice.
yes, not so a loss are to be trifled with. If both plead guilty, this but verity, that both should suffer. Ye ministers of justice, eat them hence. I cannot, will not bear such insolence.
Thank you.